Ah, good. I thought we were going to come into today spicy, ready, raw. And then I realized I didn't have RJW installed, so I threw Captain Radiator right back in that machine. And we are good to go. Now we have Captain Radiator, man of the hour. Bigger, stronger than ever, with only one kind of minor weakness in that he occasionally sees hallucinations and fires off his gun in random directions. Which ultimately is still the weakness that I want to try and remove. So guess what we're going to do? That's right. Right back in the pod. I'm here to live life on the edge. There is no greater excitement in life than a 20% chance of success with the strongest colonists we're ever going to see. Welcome to Rimworld, where we are the good guys, the best guys, the nicest guys on this planet. But the downside is someone snuffed the legendary cheese. And I'm not sure who snuffed this legendary cheese, but it was definitely supposed to be ready for the end of yesterday's episode. And it's gone. And it could not have come at a better time. Town charter by martial law. 15 days of non-stop combat, survival, and try not to barbecue your own people. And in exchange, Dr. Man wins. I've spent hours of my life combing through every single outfit, making sure things are perfect. All the right utilities, all the right armor. And not to mention, we got Dr. Man out here churning out masterwork and legendary rifles. We're good. We can't go much further than here. This is the end game now. I have no doubt our people can survive whatever we throw at them at this point. You send pirates or outlanders, the Order, mechanoids, I don't care, we're clapping them all. The real question is, can we clap over the course of 15 days? I don't know anybody's got that kind of endurance. So what we're looking for are big turrets, big guns, and ways to keep our weapons and armor from falling apart like they did last time. Well, shit, that couldn't have been any more perfect timing. Mechanite restoration. It's a very fancy shelf that you throw things on and it repairs it over time. But it doesn't work on a broken heart. We're gonna need a lot of components and a lot of plasteel to fund these magic shelves. I'm gonna just give them all of the non-masterwork bionics because we've got Dr. Man and that new power of his, so he can make a bunch of legendary arms and legs instead. Vanimetric power cell? Another infinite chem reactor? Dr. Man immediately coming out here and proving me right, making masterwork legs for masterwork people. Much like you, people watching this episode. An actual mech cluster. The first we've had the entire game. Wow. Well, that's already not that bad at all. I guess it depends what comes out of the capsules at this point. Now, how many drop beacons you got there? Oh, this is easy. Damn, they seem to have some sort of invisible energy shield. This seems like a job for none other than Major Break Risk. Boom, shield. Speed burst, Major Break Risk, speed burst. Invisibility. Get in there, take those shields out. Oh, you fools. Right behind enemy lines. Backfire, bring them down. Take out the lot. Holy crap, the range on it. Incredible. Get him, Flamio Hotman. Dr. Man, that's a job for you, my friend. I'm Major Break Risk just casually behind enemy lines, dismantling all of their turrets. I don't give a shit about your apparel right now. It's over. This is absolutely 100% over. Kill them all. Major Break Risk single-handedly finessing the entire cluster while they deal with the centipedes. Absolutely incredible. Outstanding. Oh! I completely forgot about you. Fucking hell. I was so focused on making sure Dr. Man was sorted out from a just staggering amount of friendly fire, to be honest with you. Captain Radiator! The hallucination's gone, so his only downside now is his weakness to toxic radiation. But if I'm remembering correctly, he's wearing armor that gives 100% toxic sensitivity reduction, right? Oh, he's not? Ah, no, he is. We're fine. Much like all the important things in life, it's only the head that matters. These med pods are broken. They're so fucking good. Dr. Man walks in pieces because of all this attempted mutiny. Walks out as if he's never seen a battlefield in his life. Oh! The commenters? Holy shit. From 112 to 50. So each commenter is worth almost twice as much as your regular commenter. Tragically though, double nothing is still nothing. Holy crap. No, no, no. Hang on. That is 224% manipulation. I mean, they do only have stone axes and clubs and spears, we're not that bothered. The new, the improved, the perfect Captain Radiator. Have some fun, my friend. Ah, everything's back the way it should be. Gunning down commenters en masse from across the horizon where they are none the wiser. The only issue is they might be able to genuinely outrun him because they're all twice as good as a regular commenter. We didn't finish the fucking walls. Hacker man, what are you doing? Practicing martial arts? Well, thank God you got all that fucking practicing, because of your oversight, you're going to be doing real martial arts. Excuse me. I have to ask you to leave. Oh. Well, they actually did leave. All you have to do is ask them politely. The commenters, with their expert strategy, choose to attack in small groups, rather than using the only real advantage they have, their numbers. And overwhelming screaming. This is the greatest metaphor I've ever seen. Thank you, Captain Radiator. You can go home now. Look at his recreation. He's having a whale of a time out there. It just occurred to me the disturbing reality of making a man called the Tickler our warden. So Tickler is the only person in the entire colony who doesn't have powers. I mean, Fisto the Third just doesn't need to eat food, which isn't really a power. The man's gonna live his life, never eating a quesadilla again. It's a curse, if anything. Running this experiment has a 0% chance of failure. It never stops being a constant fever dream, does it? I don't know why, but this whole thing really makes me miss Gary's mod. Yeah, no, actually, that's why. Yeah, you've reminded me. Oh, we need 2 more active speakers. Damn it, I think I didn't build them the first time around because we didn't have enough steel, but now we're more than good. News of this valuable lung will spread across the world. So we had a drop pod fall with somebody with paralytic abasia. The fuck did you just do to that rat? Oh, they're evil rats. Must be what was left over from that comment of raid a second ago. So we had this horrifying ghoul in a drop pod with paralytic abasia. I want to see if we can tend it with the med pod. I assume you can't, because that'd be even more broken than it already is, right? How do I force you into the med pod? Maybe that'll do it. Hang on. And then, carry rabbit, rescue rabbit. Hey, there you go. Now we play the waiting game? Oh! No! That's too good. I mean, shit, it did cost us an AI persona core, but you would think it would take a little bit longer. Well, goodbye, rabbit. Enjoy your new naked existence amongst the stars. Or at this point, amongst 300 copies of Major Break Risk. What's going on with all these infinite chem reactors? I'm happy to make a collection of infinite chem reactors. It's like every exotic goods trader has them. I mean, I'm not complaining. I deal exclusively in infinite chem reactors. This is very silly. this is very, very silly. We need to build a whole new building for infinite chem reactors. Oh, no. Do we give the tickler lightning, which does tickle, I assume, or plasteel claws so you can do impressive tickles? They're both very good. I will admit, the creepy warden called the tickler who doesn't say anything but just kind of gives you a little bit of a zap, I'm into that. I mean, I'm not into that. Okay, that was terrible phrasing. This is a whole new power we haven't seen yet. Hey, tickler, come with me a second. Let's tickle that ostrich. Huh? Yeah? Yeah, I think that works. Oh, Dr. Man. Dr. Man, you need to stop this madness. Now, if there's one thing their psychic powers won't work on, it's surface-to-surface missiles. I hope. I really do hope. Bees! Industrial bees for our industrial cheese. Cheese and honey, famously maybe the best combination. If you're a fucking psychopath. Thank you, military turrets. You've served us well, but your time is done, my friends. It's autocannon time. Oh, no, it is absolutely not autocannon time. Maybe it's rocket turret time? No, it's not rocket turret time either. Shit, what can I build? Sentry guns? Okay. Flame turrets? Psychic powers probably don't work against those. I'm also very tempted to thicken all of the walls, given that the psychic powers were able to hit last time through a 20-block range. Am I going to make all of these walls 20 blocks thick? How much concrete do we have? 2,000. 20 blocks thick takes us up to here. Okay, and then if we do that for the entire wall. That's quite expensive. Why don't we start with just a nice, simple block on each side? God, I'm really hoping this solves our plasteel problem. A smarter person probably wouldn't have deconstructed the old defenses before having the new defenses prepared. We're not smart here. We like to live on the edge. There you go. Plasteel will be ready in 5 hours. Now we just have to hope that this thing outputs, you know, like 4,000 plasteel. Otherwise, otherwise we're in a lot of trouble. Here it comes. Come on, that needs to be a lot of plasteel. Otherwise, we are in a 20. 20 plasteel. Well, that's 20 plasteel down, only another 480 to go. Who needs a fancy factory that makes plasteel out of nothing when you can get it from the sky? Not the most reliable way to go about things, but I think there's probably quite a lot at this stage, huh? 81. Yikes. So besides the lack of defenses, everything is pretty much ready to go. Everybody has masterwork and legendary weapons and armor thanks to Dr. Man. We've got a very slightly potentially overpowered med pod that can heal any ailment you can name. And we hopefully should be able to keep it up over the 15-day period because we've got a shitload of resources being churned out constantly by our factory. If you need to refuel a turret with steel or chem fuel, we've got that covered. There is a slight issue I didn't take into account. The town charter annunciator needs a persona core. And I turned our persona core into a med pod that heals everything and everybody. We just need to keep an eye on every quest that pops up, any pristine ruins, anything on the world map that's worth our time. We've just got to go for it. Speaking of which, hello? Item stash. I think there'll be a AI persona core there. And then we've also got ruins. Holy shit, Dale Cash Cow. I mean, it's not a persona core, but I'll take the 800 plasteel. That seems good. 77 Rimguai. You son of a bitch, I'm in. I'm gonna regret this, though. Well, we've more or less taken out every piece of plasteel on the map, and we've got shitloads to spare, so I might have just accidentally got us killed for no reason. Repair shelf. There we go. 8 advanced components each. Ugh. 2 of our people died from their armor breaking. I think it's a worthwhile investment. Someone in the comments suggested making it so that they would drop anything below 99% hit points. They'll put it on the shelf, it'll immediately repair, and we won't smelt it down because it won't have fallen below 50%. Big problem with that is everybody's going to be getting naked all the time. There's so much as a strong breeze out there. Armor takes 1% damage, they're throwing it on the floor. Maybe we'll say 90%. We won't go quite that extreme. Oh, no. Oh, everybody is naked. I mean, it's working as intended. The stuff is being repaired, but this is no good. Wait, they don't seem very hostile. We've seen this before. They all spawn in with Scaria, so they will go hostile again in a second. Oh, maybe it's a problem with compressed raiders. I never thought about that. Right, another issue is that Dr. Man has also stripped off his wheelchair because it fell below 90%. This isn't really a solution. I refuse to ride around in this tattered wheelchair. I'd sooner crawl. I mean, I appreciate the attempt, but it's not gonna happen, is it? You guys want to attack? Got me on edge here. We got an army of bears. Look at the fucking minimap. We got an army of bears outside the wall. Oh God. Okay, I spoke too soon. Is it all gonna start kicking in? Okay. Squad. Yep, this is bad. Backfire, get indoors. Oh, God, she's naked. No, this is bad. Backfire's also got malaria. Okay, time for some naked bear fist fighting then. Shit, 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 shit. Get it? Okay, start running. Incredible Bulk's out here for moral support. What are you doing, Incredible Bulk? Following Flamio Hotman, he is here for moral support. They're slowly trickling up, which is a horrible expression to use. A trickle of bears. So many of our people are still naked. Get in the fucking med pod. Let's send everybody else up. We could take the fight to them. Otherwise, we're just going to be sitting here waiting for them all to turn Manhunter. To be fair, they probably won't get past the turrets. Yeah, no, that seems about right. Don't fist fight the bears. You're naked. Shit. I'll be honest. I didn't see those ones there, okay? The minimap isn't exactly the most useful thing going right now. Wait, look. We can release him. The Incredible Bolt could go to war. I have an idea. Get him. Get him, Bulk. Oh, what a guy. You didn't think with all those bionics, all of those upgrades, he wouldn't have developed a little bit of intelligence, huh? You got that big brain synaptic cerebellum. He's got a circadian assistant. All this time, you thought I was going to limit it to 10 heroes. The secret 11th hero has been there all along. Well, I thought it'd be quicker to send Flamio Hotman and the Incredible Bolt just to go out there and kill them all. I think a lot of them just walked off the map as well, but I thought this would be a lot easier than waiting for them all to go nuts over them. Yeah. They just straight walked away. So at this stage, we really just are waiting for somebody to send us a bloody AI Persona Core offer. In the meantime, back to the redemption arc. Remember, Dr. Man's a better person now. He's seen the horrors of what he's inflicted on his friends. All you have to do is ask Captain Radiator, who's had a real shit time this past week. I want to upgrade Tickler more, because right now Tickler can just shoot lightning bolts, which is already pretty incredible. Really, we should be upgrading Vista, given all he can do is not be hungry. Before Tickler gets his new power, we're gonna make sure he doesn't have any weaknesses. 40% chance of failure. It's a big gamble. There it is. What a great day to be the Incredible Bulk. Craft high-tech power armor made to fit onto domestic animals. My friend, you're gonna be perfect. I wonder if there are any other bionics we can give him at this point as well, because we've unlocked quite a lot of extra stuff. So he needs another bionic lung. His manipulation is down, but he's also an elephant, so what can you do? Finally, you big lazy boy. Sucus of Megaton, it's Sucus Limbs. We've got a location of a Persona Core, which you'll need to build a spaceship, or in this case, a total martial law of the planet. We won't tell him that part. Call him with the comms console if you're interested. Suka Slims? Shit. 1,500 silver, you've got yourself a deal. You could just do it to help out for the sake of the planet, but that's all right. Suka's stash of goodies. You know, that's actually really bloody close. Send a squad. Flamio, Hotman, and Incredible Bulk. And hopefully by the time Bulk is back, we'll have a bunch of bionics and some new armor for him. We should do that first. Dr. Man, you're not allowed to go. Mad Elephants? Mad because you know you're never going to be as good as the Incredible Bulk. This will be a pretty solid test if our new defensive upgrades have been worth it. Yep, that seems pretty good. Oh no, it's so cruel. Staggeringly though, they did get past them. They got pretty damn far. Oh, and Tickler's done too. And Olive. Hello, Olive. 89 years of age. Olive, I'm sorry. We're just about to go out into all-out war, my friend. Get in the damn pod. Don't come back. What are we up against, though? We're up against a archery boom rat? An angry wall fox? Exotic pet of the ancients? I saw that. And then, oh, a big spider, but not as big as the other spiders we've seen. Unless those are massive stone blocks. Hey, that's a little lackluster then, I guess. I didn't need to send in our best for this one. Something quite poetic about watching a 4-ton elephant take out a fennec fox at range with a minigun. Brilliant. Was that it? Asuka set us up? Is this vengeance for me like all his people get savaged by death claws? There's nothing here. It was an ambush. Sukus, you son of a bitch. Well, there's the persona core. Who are we being ambushed by? Oh, it's mechanoids. Okay, well, I don't think he's that smart. Flamio Hotman, grab the persona core. Incredible Bulk, kill them all. Wow, he really is just killing them all, though. Flamio Hotman was pathetic compared to him. Double check, we've got the persona core. I'm going to take the slight box as well, because that's what we're using to make the plasteel. And then home we go. With hopefully now everything we need to build the Town Charter Annunciator. Now, this may be the first time ever I'm able to make powered armor for an animal that it's intended to fit on. Every time we've had this mod before, it's always been with modded animals. And it's not ultimately designed by that. Sure, they can wear it, but they don't get the graphical change. I want to see the Incredible Bolt wearing the power armor. If he doesn't now, I'm going to be so disappointed. What do we type in? It's like animal. Here we go. Animal power armor. Where are you? Plate armor. Maybe it's at the fabrication bench instead. So we can click off the fucking thing. Animal. Ah. There it is. I think it's a fairly safe bet that we need large animal power armor. And then large animal power armor helmet. Dr. Man just going to casually crack out some legendary elephant armor. Wow. It's beautiful. I've looked at this for 5 hours now. And there it is. The Town Charter Annunciator. So whenever we feel like we're ready, all we have to do is press the button. And hopefully not die. And as far as series go, I will admit this one has had a pretty poor record for hopefully not dying. Rarely do we lose this many key characters. Well, maybe we do. Maybe it's just because we built up the characters in this series so much with the intros and the powers and the armor. He's actually done it. Legendary large animal power armor. And this is coming from a guy who only has 14.44 crafting as well. My God, it's happening. It's happening. Turn. Show us what you look like. Oh. Incredible Bulk. Look at him. He does have a shield belt, which will stop him firing his minigun, unfortunately. So we'll have to get him to throw that on the floor in a second. My God. Look at you. You're perfect. Well, I say perfect. We can always get perfect. Perfecter. Perfect. More perfect. You will be the most powerful animal we've ever had in Rimworld, Incredible Bulk. One bionic after another. Finally, the perfect Rimworld character. Oh, you absolute fools. I was saving that cluster for when Bulk was ready. Wow, that's a lot of fucking mechanoids we've got to deal with. They're taking apart my walls. Never do charity. Never help anybody because they'll try and help you. And the only person you can ever rely on in this world is yourself. Oh my God, if naked bear fistfighting wasn't bad enough, Tickler just ran in naked too. I thought I'd rounded up all the naked people, then he snuck his armor off at the last moment. Stupid Scyther. Ah, yeah, you know what? That probably isn't helping the situation, is it? My fucking defenses. Whenever I think we're safe and ready to go, shit like this happens. Look at it! Actually, this is why naked squad will come in handy, because these carpenters aren't going to attack I'm gonna attack our naked people. Oh lord. Wow, those centipedes are so fucking tanky. Even with what we've got now, that took the whole squad to bring it down. Excuse me. This is private property. Your lucky CEO incredible bulk isn't awake, otherwise you'd all be done for. Actually, let's bring them a little closer. I wonder if lightning would work on them. That's a good thing to test out. Turns out not at all. Okay, we'll go with the old classic then. Dr. Man, finish the job. What happened there? We weren't anywhere near that. Okay. Well, that was something. I wonder if Captain Radiator got off a shot on some... on some unstable power supplies or something. Why, thank you. I will use that to make more cheese. You're right. I'm gonna lock the doors. Nobody gets any more cheese. No more quality in 1.7 days. Are we gonna see any before we finish this freaking series? That's it. I'm sick of this now. You're all done for. 50 of them from the algorithm. And they're sieging. They're trying to stop Incredible Bulk, but you can't stop the Incredible Bulk. He is inevitable. Inevitable Bulk. Oh god, they put up a shield against Dr. Man. Does it still work though? That's the real question. I didn't. The shield caught it. Okay. Driver Mad, get yourself some cover. Get out of there. Laser Linda. Laser Linda's out. Oh shit. Flameo Hotman has laser eyes. The problem is, Flameo Hotman is another naked boy. Okay, that was a bit of a whiff. The fuck is that? Pumpkin spice coffee. Okay, let's try this again. Oh, I don't like that sound. Okay, ready? End them. I can't see them. Come on, come on, come on. Come on, here we go, here we go, here we go. Okay, well, thank God for that mechanoid shield. Like I was saying, end them. Flame your Hotman. End them. Flame your Hotman. End them, though. Please. Okay. That was horrible. That was a massive gamble. Holy shit, that shield completely dissipated that Doomsday rocket launcher. And with that, our bionic upgrades for our elephant are complete. That is every single possible installable bionic that's compatible with a big old elephant, some of which are a little debatable. This is the largest brain elephant you're probably ever gonna see. We've got joy wires, we've got synaptic cerebellum, circadian assistance, neurocalculators, and learning assistance. Not the incredible bot that's gonna learn a lesson. It's the order. I mean, the defibrillator was good, and so was Silencer, of course, but futuristic cyber elephant wasn't on my bingo card of heroes. So unless we are missing any limbs elsewhere, I am finally happy to say we're done. There is nowhere else we can go from here. The armor sets are very, very powerful. The weapons are legendary, or masterwork at least. I think it's time we deal with some age-old enemies. Since the start of this entire thing, two factions have plagued us most of all. Besides the order, of course. The algorithm, who took Megaton, the actual city from the faction, very, very early on. Then controlling No Man's Land, right in the center of the continent, we have the commenters. I think it's time we show them both out. Let's get rid of these old, overused helicopters. Friendship ended with a little bird. Venom Snake is my new best friend. My god, it's gigantic. I spent all our damn gold on advanced components. Yeah, I don't know why. I don't get a very good feeling about you, my friend. Just get that strange impression that this isn't gonna go as planned. All right, look, everybody, it's Judas. The first thing he's done is take off his trousers. My Judas, is that the spear of Longinus in your pocket, or are you just happy to see me? No offense there, friend, but honestly, I think I'm all right. Now, we could send Captain Radiator to every single one of these settlements and watch them melt. But that is the type of thing a villain would do, treating him like a mindless weapon. We need to prove to this world that we're here to defend them. All of us are here to defend them. By which I mean four of us are here to defend them. Because it's a... I mean, they're very heavy, okay? I want to use up all that extra fuel just on that. Take them out, boys. Take them out. Teach these goddamn commenters a lesson. Stop parking the helicopters in stupid places. Oh my god, oh my god! Did you see that? So anyway, I started blasting. Are they trapped? What the hell are they doing? Like trashing their own bathroom. Really is just wonderful to watch. Where are they coming from? They're coming out of the goddamn walls. I guess they were camping in these... What the fuck? Reactor console? I guess they were camping in the ruins of this base and don't have the keys to it? Look at this place. 17 Luciferium, 32 Glitz of World Medicine. Must want to explore. But we do have bigger fish to fry right now. Well then, team, let's get out of here. Well, unless it's going to show me on this screen what we can loot. No, I didn't think so. Oh, no. I mean, there's a lot of them, sure, but probably not for long. Get him, squad. Kill them all. Wow, the way we're going, they might actually do some damage to the helicopter. Oh! Is that it? I think that might be the end of the commenters. We've scattered them. They have been... Get out of here. They have been defeated. Once again, pleasing the terrifying hive. I want to see a trade caravan turn up with mega spiders and muffalo. Look at this place. Hydroponics basin? Oh, it was a giant spider. I hope we didn't have to kill that before we leave. We may have to send some chem fuel over for this one. My god, the algorithm have similar armor to what we have. Okay, squad. Maybe we should back off and get behind some cover then. This one might not be as straightforward as killing a bunch of savage commenters. Get them backfire. Blast them. Nice. Nice. Ah, watch the helicopter. Oh, that'll do it. Yeah, that'll... Ah! Oh! We just nuked? What was that? Boom! What the fuck? I assume someone's got a railway rifle. Maybe it's just the last train leaving the ass whooping town. Fucking hell. We don't have a good catchphrase, do we, for the faction? We don't have any sort of call sign or anything. Captain Radiator has now got the too smart trait. Oh, we're supposed to be the good guys, and he's getting a little bit conceited there, Captain Radiator. Thinks he's too good. He's defeated everybody. There's no one left to fight. Yeah, this is going to be our last run, so let's go over to Guzzle. And that means after this, there is only one place for the algorithm remaining. That was, again, a horrible place to land. Well, I thought we'd won. There's an ominous banging coming from that building. Hello? Anybody there? Weird. They keep spawning in bases they don't have the keys to. Off we go to the final of our enemy settlements. And you may have figured that out already, but that means that when we activate the town charter, all 15 days of our survival are going to be our most mortal enemies of all. Either Mechanoids or the Order. The Order, who seems to be... What the hell are you doing there? Building outposts? I know. They know that war is coming. The algorithm is dead. Long live the algorithm. Well, I mean, they might kill us. I doubt it, but they might. Is that name in Cyrillic? I've never seen that before. And that's it. We are done. Since this was their last settlement, the algorithm has been defeated. We're not taking any trophies. We're not taking any prisoners. We're just going to breathe a sigh of relief that they're gone. But be sad that they forced us to do it. I took absolutely no pleasure in watching the culmination of our super soldier program with our exceptionally powerful armor, our legendary weapons, and our superpowers glowing down wave after wave after wave of enemies. And sure, the glory might be unrivaled and it might have been an utter spectacle to behold, but we're definitely sad because it happened. So, so sad. All that remains are allied or neutral factions, the remains of the commenters and the algorithm who have been scattered out there into the world. And of course, our greatest enemy of all, the Order, who tomorrow we're going to try and survive against. We're going to see if all of this building, all of these powers, we can apply and win. And not just win, but win, hopefully, with some sort of style, knowing that we defeated what I thought was for a while there an undefeatable enemy. Thank you, of course, to the most undefeatable people of all, the patrons. Thank you to Gamajude, Rising Phoenix, Pandemic, Adam Spleen, Oliver, Kish, Lord Condog, Neo Zila, Guardian Easter, Chax, Tungsten Heart, Nanon 10, Silent Sentinel, Out of All Context, Arabs, Secret, and Kane for their support of the executive producer tiers over on Patreon. Thank you as well to Laser Gaming, Dion, Wifty, Yolgi, Roger, Wilco, Nightbee, Lyneth, Marcus Absent, Ractanian, Sangri, The Gentleman Ghostronaut, McFluffy, The Fluffiest of Fluffies, Kippos, Scott, Abacus, Mantle, Dreamer, and Grumpy Furball. See you all tomorrow for victory or death. Or both. Probably both. Well, that's a little awkward. I just finished editing the video and it's like, I cut out so much. It's a minute short today. So what I thought I would do is at the end of the episode here, throw in a little bonus for you all to pump the video time beyond 30 minutes. Otherwise, people complain. It could be 29 minutes, 59 seconds. I see people complaining. Despite the fact that we've had episodes this week closer to 40 minutes, but that's not the point. So I'm going to sit here, and for the remainder of what we have left in today's episode, I will tell you my deepest, darkest secrets. Before we do that, though, let's do the classic. Anybody watching this far, if you're hearing this moment, leave a comment. leave a comment that just says elephant. Just elephant, nothing else. Be our little joke between me and you. It'll also boost up the interaction on the video, which is always a great help to the channel. Now, I did promise you my deepest, darkest secrets for the remainder of this video, of course. So why don't we start with the deepest, darkest secret to soften the rest of them coming up. My truest, darkest secret is that I once...